so wholly commonly debated.
My name is Jennifer Huppert. I'm the President of the Jewish Community Council of Victoria, and I'm standing here with Ahmet Keskin, the Executive Director of the Australian Intercultural Society, and we are your hosts for this, the fourth Not So Holy Comedy debate.
We're at Mount Sinai. You heard this? Is it appropriate? Because we're all desert people, aren't we? Yeah. Muslims and we're all at the foot of Mount Sinai. And whoever it was got the Ten Commandments. Right? No names. No names. And then, as they left with the Ten Commandments, the voice came and said, "Hey! Come back." And back they trotted, and there was a scrap of paper on the ground. And he said, "Read what's on the paper." So they had their Ten Commandments and they picked up the piece of paper and read it, and it said, none of those will work without these two, compassion and common sense.
So I lost a testicle, and I got to say, one huge advantage of losing a testicle, finally feel comfortable in skinny jeans, finally, finally. Finally, up until now, I thought my jeans were too tight. No, I had one too many testicles. That was the problem. By the way, this is the weird part of the night, you know, when I tell people I've lost a testicle, and now I feel like a woman with big boobs. Because you're all maintaining eye contact. But you really want to look down, don't you? Get stuck into it, guys, okay? I'm trying to prove to you that laughter's the best medicine. Have a crack, it's fine. You gotta have a sense of humour, right? Like, you gotta have a sense of humour. I told a friend of mine that I lost a testicle, and he goes to me, "Oh, so when you have sex, it must look like an exclamation mark." I said, "No. I've got a curve, so it's more of a question mark, actually."
Laughter is not the best medicine. As a Jewish woman, I know what the best medicine is. It's chicken soup. I was in the bagel belt the other... Thank you. I was in the bagel belt the other week, and a man collapsed on Carlisle Street. It was awful, just collapsed. And a bubba walked past and said, maybe we should give him chicken soup. And they said, "We think he's dead," and she said, "Still worth a try." The other side are no doubt going to use obscure Scandinavian studies, blah, blah, health benefits, blah, blah, comedy, blah, blah, blah. Frankly, it is a perilous position to put your health into a punchline. Very perilous.
The other thing I learned is Bob's also not my uncle. Even though everyone in Australia keeps telling me he's my uncle, look at me, I'm African. My uncle's name is Matumbo Baba. Someone finally told me that Bob, your uncle, was just an Australian slang. Yeah, it's just an Australian slang, like don't get your knickers in a knot, crack a tinny, and my favourite, go back to your country.
Now, Justine, you said that chicken soup is the best medicine. I'll do you one better. There is one superfood that is halal. So yes, we are supporting ISIS when you buy it. And it'll make you feel amazing at 2 a.m. in the morning. It's a kebab. Who has ever had the munchies at 2 a.m. after a wild night out? and then you feel empty, like there's a void in your souls. And you walk past those flashing neon lights as if you were a mosquito staring at the blue light, and you automatically start going, even though you know it's not good for you. You just keep going. And then you order that kebab and it comes to you, and the sweaty, hairy guy just passes it over to you, and you, the only thing you can do is say Bismillah. Even Pauline Hanson says it, guys, come on.
Laughing at home has been one of the most cathartic experiences since my dad passed away. It has been fantastic for my healing. For example, my mum, she's terrified of bugs. She grew up in a village in rural China, but somehow still highly afraid of anything that's like cockroaches or has more than four legs. And she was yelling at the carpet one night when it appeared that there was a giant cockroach running around on the floor. And then upon closer inspection, it turned out to be a piece of cooked red onion. And so we laughed. And that has been one of my favourite memories from this year, and it proves laughter does bring people together. And to conclude, if you don't laugh, you will cry. And that's why we are all here tonight rather than watching Q&A at home. We want to forget our problems for just an hour or two. Compared to the negative team, who are in fact negative Nancys who hate fun, my team is qualified to vouch for the fact laughter is the best medicine. We have a medical professional, a cancer survivor, and a burn survivor with a dead dad. If you walk away from this debate having laughed instead of bawling your eyes out, then we have already won. Thank you.
There are 8 hospitals in the world called Jewish Hospital. You can look that up. 8 hospitals in the world. Do you know how many hospitals you need to have before you run out of rich Jews to name them after and then settle with Jewish? A lot. Jews love building hospitals. The only thing that Jews love more than not spending money is spending money on a hospital. Because everyone that way knows that you were rich enough that's it. We all know that, right? People that give to charity are showing that they're rich. We know it. No? Okay? Okay. Okay, great. Yeah, give to charity, you're beautiful. Yeah, okay. Jews are 0.2% of the world's population, but we love medicine so much that Jews have won 28% of the Nobel Prizes for medicine. Jews, we love medicine so much that even when Jews don't do something in medicine, we still take credit. Like the inventor of penicillin was Andrew Fleming, but the person that won the Nobel Prize for discovering how to use it, Ernst Haeckel, Jewish. The person who did the first ever heart transplant, I wrote it down, Christian Barnard. But it was done on a Jew. You think we're letting Christian take credit for that? No way. Shout out to my man, Louis Wyszkanski, who had the bravery of getting that heart transplant.
For those of you who want to vote for the affirmative side, that laughter is the best medicine, please join now and clap your hands and we'll measure the sound. So. That's a pretty impressive response. And now if we could have those who wish to support the negative team that laughter is not the best medicine. Call, but we've conferred, yes. And we think that in this year that the prize, the winner goes to the negative team, which is Justine Sless, Jacob Sacher and Jim.
Done.
Mazel tov to the Shtick after 600 episodes.